Welcome to the next teaching unit in the chapter PV grid integration. We'll now take a look at the influence of the connection of a PV system on the voltage in the grid and the significance of reactive power in this context. Here you can see once again the different voltage level of a power grid. The voltage levels are coupled by the transformers of the substations or local network stations, which transform the voltage between the two respective voltage levels. From extra high voltage to medium voltage, the substations are each equipped with regulators that can adjust the transformation ratio between two voltage levels. This means, for example, that the voltage on the medium voltage side can be kept approximately constant, even though the voltage on the high voltage side fluctuates due to wind feed-in. Only between medium voltage and low voltage, a fixed transformation ratio is given usually. Due to the fixed transformation ratio, the voltage on the low voltage side changes with the voltage on the medium voltage sides of the transformer. Generally, a nominal voltage is specified for each voltage level. However, the actual voltage will vary somewhat due to different load and generation situations. If the voltage deviates significantly up or down from the specified nominal voltage, various problems can occur. Overvoltages stress the insulation and reduce the lifetime of the equipment. Undervoltage, on the other hand, can in the worst case lead to an uncontrollable drop in the main voltage. This effect is called voltage collapse and can lead to a complete or partial failure of the power supply system. Therefore, limits for the permissible voltage deviations are specified. In Europe, these limits are specified in the DIN EN 50160 standard. According to it, the voltage in each voltage level must be within a tolerance band of plus minus 10% of the nominal voltage. Since the voltages of the low and medium voltage grids are rigidly coupled, the available voltage band of plus minus 10% must be divided between the medium and the low voltage bands. Since most PV systems are connected to these two grid levels, let's take a closer look at the voltage band here. First, we have the substation between the high and the medium voltage grid. In German power grid, the voltage here is transformed from 110 kV to 20 kV in rural areas and 10 kV in urban areas. In the medium voltage grid, some consumers and power plants are connected. In the local network stations, the voltage is finally transformed to 400 volts, with which households are supplied in the low voltage grid. In addition, feed-in from small PV systems also takes place here. Often, the grid operator sets a voltage slightly above the nominal voltage at the substation upstream of the medium voltage grid. From here, the power must be transported via more or less long lines to the consumers. This results in a voltage drop, as we have already seen in the sizing of lines for PV systems. The greater the power transported, the greater the voltage drop. Exactly the opposite case occurs when power is not drawn in but feed in. Here, there's a voltage increase at the feed-in point. If the feeding inverter would not set the voltage higher, the current could not flow towards the grid at all. And just as with the voltage drop, the grid operator must ensure that the voltage at every point in the grid remains within the voltage band, even at maximum feed-in. To ensure that the voltage is always within the voltage band, the following two extreme cases must be considered. The highest voltage occurs when the feed-in is at its maximum, but the consumption is at a minimum. To ensure that even in this case the voltage is within the voltage band, in Germany 2% is reserved for the voltage rise due to the feed-in at the medium voltage level and 3% for feed-in at the low voltage level. The opposite extreme case, that is the lowest voltage, occurs when consumption is at a maximum and feed-in at a minimum. In the low voltage grid, this can be the case in a winter evening, for example, when hardly any PV is feed-in to be expected. The remaining distribution of the voltage band varies among the different grid operators. Typically, 5% each is allocated for the voltage drop in the medium voltage and the low voltage grid. In addition, 2% is allocated for voltage regulatory inaccuracy at the substation and 1.5% each for voltage rise and drop at the local grid transformer. If a PV system is connected to the low or medium voltage grid, it must be checked beforehand whether an impermissible voltage increase is to be expected as a result. In Germany, this check is carried out by the grid operator. However, if the voltage increase is too high, this does not mean that the PV system cannot be connected per se. There are a number of ways to counteract the voltage rise caused by a PV system. Let us now try to calculate how high the voltage increase due to a PV system actually is. To get an idea, we'll first create an equivalent circuit diagram of the grid. Both the lines and the transformer have an ohmic resistance R and a reactance X. To simplify matters, we combine the two into a common resistance and a common reactance of the grid. At the beginning of the line, we feed in a voltage V inverter with our inverter, so that the current I flows. From the point of view of the inverter, the resistance and the reactance of the grid cause a voltage drop delta V, which is composed of the voltage VR and VX. From the point of view of the grid, the voltage of course is increased. The grid voltage is marked here by VG. Thus, to calculate delta V, we only need to calculate VR and VX. The voltage drop across the ohmic resistance of the grid is caused by the active component of the current. According to Ohm's law, we can also calculate this from the coefficient of active power to grid voltage. For the voltage drop across the reactance, on the other hand, we only have to consider the reactive component of the current. As with the active current, the reactive current is equal to the coefficient of the reactive power to the grid voltage. Since reactive and active power are related by the phase angle phi, we can further simplify this term and finally obtain the equation shown here. Not surprisingly, the voltage rise depends significantly on the active power P fed into the grid. We also see that in addition to the magnitude of R and X, the phase shift set on the inverter also has an effect on the voltage rise. Let's take a closer look at the influence of the phase shift or the displacement factor. In this figure shown here, you can see the voltage increase that results relative to the grid voltage for different displacement factors. The calculation of the diagram was based on an Rx ratio typical for a low voltage grid in Germany. The upper line results from a somewhat larger plant with 25 kilowatt peak, the lower line for a smaller plant with 7.5 kilowatt peak. If the inverter of the plant feeds in with a power factor of 1, thus without a phase shift between current and voltage, the result is a voltage increase of 3.4%. This is just above the limit provided by the grid operator. For the smaller system, the voltage rise is significantly lower. If we now set an inductive phase shift on the inverter, the voltage rise drops significantly. With a larger PV system, it can be reduced by 0.5 percent points with a power factor of 0.95. Setting such a phase shift at the inverter means nothing else than that it absorbs inductive reactive power from the grid in addition to feeding in active power. Because of this context, today the ability to absorb reactive power is mandatory for almost all newly installed PV systems in Germany. Let's take a brief look at what this means in practice and consider a plant with 10 kilowatt peak. The grid operator specifies that a fixed cosine phi of 0.95 must be set on the inverter. With a cosine phi of 0.95, the ratio of active to apparent power is 95%. For the dimensioning of the inverter, it is not the active power, but the apparent power that is decisive. The inverter must therefore be designed a little more than 5% larger in order to be able to feed in the required reactive power. If the grid operator requires a cosine phi of 0.95, the inverter must even be designed more than 10% larger. In Germany, a cosine phi of 0.9 may be demanded for plants with a size of 14 watt peak and above. In addition to the setting of a fixed cosine phi, there's also the possibility to control the cosine phi depending on the feed-in active power. Likewise, the reactive power can be controlled according to the voltage of the connection point. This is also referred to as QV control. The advantage of QV control is that the PV systems can also contribute to voltage stability when the grid voltage is too low. In Germany, the grid operator decides which method is to be used by a plant. Various means are used to counteract the voltage rise caused by photovoltaic system on the part of the grid. One of these is an expansion of the grid so that more lines are available for generators and consumers. This reduces the reactance and resistance at the connection point. In addition, grid operators can replace the fixed local grid transformers with adjustable local grid transformers. This allows the voltages between the medium voltage and the low voltage grids to be decoupled so that a wider voltage band is available for feed-in at both grid levels. The decision to expand the lines or replace the local network transformer is essentially an economic one, made and borne by the grid operator. Let's summarize this teaching unit. We've learned that the connection of a PV system results in an increase in the grid voltage at the connection point. The amount of voltage rise depends on the active power fed into the grid, the resistance and reactance of the grid, and the phase shift of the inverter. To reduce the voltage rise, inductive reactive power can be drawn from the grid by a phase shift at the inverter. Various methods are used to draw reactive power, fixed cosine phi, active power dependent cosine phi control and voltage dependent Q control. Other possibilities to reduce the voltage rise are an expansion of the grid or the use of an adjustable local grid transformer. I thank you for your attention.